And now this is also a winner's finals match.
This is going to be a crazy match.
For pool 7.
This is like a top 8 match we're getting right now. This is awesome.
So we're going to have Xian going up against Julio.
Yep, Julio, NorCal OG Third Strike player. Mm-hmm. I would call him OG. But
hey, you know what? Look, at this point in time, even 09ers are veterans. You know what I mean? Seriously.
Yeah, I guess.
Dude, they've been playing for like 7 or 8 years now, right?
I mean, Street Fighter time? Yeah, that's not that long. No, it is.
But look, Julio was really, really good at Third Strike. He was also very good at Street Fighter 4, and a lot of people just chalked it up to him using Yun. They were like, you're only good because your character was good. And a lot of people didn't give Julio a lot of the credit that I felt like he deserved. Because even after Yun got nerfed between AE and AE 2012, he still stuck with Yun, and he did really well.
Oh yeah, he loves Yun.
Yeah, Yun got. That's
why I was saying I was so surprised that he even touched this game, because Yun wasn't in it. Yeah, that's how much he likes that character. Where he just doesn't play a game.
Right. You figured he would have taken the rest with the Yun list, right?
Yeah.
But he's going to be going with. Who does he play in this game? He plays
Ken. Come on, man.
Right, that's right. He got top 8 at Winter Ball with Ken. And his Ken is really good. His Ken is really ferocious.
He's pretty aggressive. You know, I think he's out of like all the Ken players in the States, I think he's the most aggressive Ken.
Yeah.
No, maybe to a fault.
I kept thinking, Yun.
And then
who does he play now? Yeah. But here comes Fong. Of course, we saw Xian with Fong earlier on stream. Just using Ryo Benda just to challenge the fireball,
that
really.
Light Ryo Benda, that's right. Yeah. Light kick Ryo Benda is what's going to nullify the fireballs as fast as some recovery, too. So.
And it bounces him back a little bit.
I don't think that one bounces him back.
Oh, that's right. You're right. It's only the medium and the heavy ones that bounce back. Ooh, nice. Okay. Sneaking in with the little coward crouch kick.
Maybe just bounced back. Who knows about this?
Dude, the game is new.
Yeah.
You can't expect us to know everything about.
One. Did you see that? He whipped one and he bounced back. So.
We do. There's no way for us to know everything about this game so early. I'm sorry. You can't challenge. If you challenge, it has to be a move that knocks down
right.
Or something that makes you move forward.
That's right. Yeah.
Like Cammy can do low forward drill. Oh, he's still in. Oh no, that's plus. Gotta be careful.
You gotta watch out. You gotta know when to attack this character.
Oh, he gets to the other side. Gets to the other side with that cancellation into the EX step.
So that's the actual mix up here with the character.
Yeah.
Which is what we're talking about. You want to contest the fireball that he has, right? And you want to do that with sweep and these big buttons to get a knockdown. But there actually is a mind game there. You can cancel it to the EX run. So you gotta watch out, which is invincible to attacks. Not frozen. Good combo right there. No overhead or no anti-air. Gets the knockdown. The EX rush is safe. Runs up. Steals the turn. Gets the knockdown.
Ooh. Gets out of there.
Gets out of there.
Yeah.
And you can, this is a little theory fighter for people, but you can't jump cancel his EX run if you want to avoid throws as well. So there you go. If you're going to do EX run on wake up, might as well try to jump cancel it.
Right. But then it's not a true reversal, so that's the dangerous part right there. Oh, here we go. Big damage from Julio. Oh, no.
Gets out of there. He's good. Yeah. That's the sound I hear in my
head.
Yeah,
I know. Because it's that crab walk. It's Zoidberg, right?
I was thinking like Three Stooges. But you're right. Yeah.
Oh, man. Every time I see that. Oh, nice. Using the sleeves, getting right through there.
1-1. One game apiece. Meter is equal. Nice uppercut. Gets the first, first blood.
Caught him right from behind there. Almost made it behind.
I like how he uses that stand strong. Look at that. You don't see that from Kansas. Stand strong, canceling to rear benders. Ooh, whiffs that stand fierce. Ken throws that stand fierce. You know, he's trying to cake you when he throws that stand fierce.
Nice. It's another one of those satisfying buttons, especially when it crush counters and you run and cancel into something.
Because it's a hook. It's like a hood hook, you know? Like you're trying to put him out.
It's the moneymaker right there.
All right,
okay,
good
job.
Oh, all three of them. Look at him run up too. Ken's such a sick character.
Dude, I feel like the game is moving in fast motion right now. What is going on?
Oh, he beats it again, but he was ready.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, but then the wake up zero from Shin is going to take
it. Oh, no.
And yeah, both of them are like, I can't believe that wake up zero worked.
That was that was a little wonky.
Oh, my God.
You got to do what you got to do to win, though.
Seriously, though, that one sequence, everything was going so fast.
That was pretty quick. That was some fast thinking from both players. I'm amazed, actually, that Julio reacted so quickly to that EX run.
Right? That was so good.
That was wild.
I wonder if there's an option selected to that.
You can crash me fireball, and then you kind of do like a
backwards uppercut kind of thing.
Exactly.
You know? Yeah, because it won't do anything if he doesn't cancel, right? He has no reverse uppercut special move.
You could do that. Oh, ouch. You could do that with target combos. There's ways to put in option selects built
into it. Right, look at this pressure from Julio.
Good hit confirm.
Oh, I love this pressure.
And look, you can see all this stuff. Not all of it, but some of it is just him stealing turns because it's just a flurry of moves coming at you. You're not sure when you should hit a button.
Yep. Here it comes.
Punish.
Gonna get a lot of extra damage on that poison. I mean, not a lot, but enough.
It adds up, and then plus the white health, like it all adds up. You know?
The white health, you can't gain back. You see right there? It's never coming back.
Right.
So that's the advantage right there. One of the advantages on poison.
Cancels it, goes for a crush counter setup. Doesn't get anything after that. Now they're equal at health.
Dude, I loved how Julio took like that tiny step to low block the Ryobenda. He's gonna be able to get with the EX uppercut. That should be enough to take that round.
Julio, here we go. He needs to make something happen. So this is pretty important that he gets a round on the board on the second match because he does not want to have his back up against the wall so quickly. It's very important to win that first round. Nice run through the fireball right there.
Ooh.
Fang got a lot of tools.
Oh, baited out the throw. Cancel him with the step in.
Yep.
I just love that step. It just looks so methodical. Like,
it's a very good move. Very good for characters who don't have a three frame. Throw.
Oh, crush counter time.
Stun. Oh, he's not there.
Oh, there it is. The poison got him stunned. Oh, he went for a trickiness.
That was pretty cool. Good tech from Julio. Okay, here we go.
Surprised that Julio was ready for that.
Set point for Razor Shen. A little wacky neutral game right there. They were just kind of hitting buttons. Nothing really worked. Nobody was walking. They just opted to stand in place and hit things.
You're right. That standing strong in the Ryobender is so cool.
He's getting a lot of mileage out of that.
Yeah,
look at that. Every time he loves using it. Ken with the EX Hurricane Kick in the air. Very strong move. Surprised they gave him that in this game. Here we go. What kind of mix up?
You
just hit buttons on wake up.
I don't care about your knees.
Yep. Some disrespectful play going on because he knows he needs to make something happen. EX fireball to blow through that.
Ooh, didn't erase that fireball.
There was none. It was the light one.
Yeah. There it is. Oh, it makes
runs
it through.
Through
nice.
It.
Good stuff.
Now he has him cornered. This could be potentially very bad.
Oh,
the DP, crush counter, run, fierce, the setup. Oh, look how much stun that built up.
Here comes Julio's chance. He's got to get in there. Oh, no.
Beautiful
using the V-trigger. He gets through there.
He
gets it.
Julio takes game two.
Wow.
He got away with one, though.
Yeah.
Boy, did he get away with one. He got that random jump and then just a throw.
Yeah.
And there was no punish. There was nothing. Shan was probably just completely surprised that even happened.
All right, good stuff. Julio making that comeback, bringing it to the third game. Again, this is winner's finals of Pool 7.
Oh, he's clubbing away at him. These buttons, this is what happens. You start bullying, but eventually, you know, you got to stand up for yourself. They've had enough of this.
You got to pile drive the bullies.
Yeah, I know, right? You can't be out of that.
Ooh, wow, that erased the fireball and was far enough to hit Ken.
Yeah. So that's kind of interesting.
Ooh, he chased it down. He saw the step.
Combo. Got a hit right there. And sometimes when you get a hit and then you get the run, they'll respect your buttons.
Right, right.
So that's why the players cancel moves in the run. They expect them to hit.
Okay, no longer poison. If he gets any closer, he
will
be
poisoned. Good trade for Ken right there, though.
Yep, poisoned again.
A lot of times when you trade with certain anti-airs, find out if you win that damage trade or not.
Big damage right here.
And the mix-up, and he's just poisoned. Not enough,
here
though.
Comes
all about the mix-up right here.
Gets out.
Let's get out. Ooh, EX Fireball did not hit him at the frames where that move eats up fireballs yet.
Right, right. And it was key that he used the EX. His EX is much faster startup.
Right. And it eats fireballs.
Yep.
So he's probably just thinking, this move is garbage. Because it's like you do it at the right time and it still doesn't work. It's one of those things.
Yep.
Yeah. But it is one of those moves where it has to be actually active, I think, in order for it to do its job. It is quick, so yeah. And again, that stand strong and a crouch strong kind of sequence right there, very useful.
Julio is at match point now when it looked like it was all going Xian's way. Xian not using that down fierce as anti-air as often.
You know what? He's lucky he didn't, because Julio knows the forbidden Kenta, which is the jump Tatsu. For some reason, it beats every single normal anti-air. I cannot explain why.
Interesting. Okay.
Yeah, it works though. Go test it versus like Armin.
Oh, that's done.
Nice.
All right. So now back to match point for Xian as well. Match point for both players. This is the last round for this.
Oh, starts the match with EX. He's not messing around. Yeah, he's going.
Oh, he made it over. He made it over. But he didn't get the full combo.
Another EX. Wow, he is trying to like make a quick statement in the beginning of this fight.
Yeah, I mean, well, that's the thing. It's like
Petra
from watching.
Has cornered. EX out, gets punished.
Yeah.
Thrown into a corner. Here we go. Work time. No, you don't. He tried to get out of there. Now he's just jumping.
Oh, he gets out with the jump. So smart.
Wow, that was messy, though. I wouldn't call that smart. That was gutsy. It worked.
Brave.
It was brave.
It was
there
brave.
You
there you go.
Very brave. Nice. Antier's reaction is so
good. Oh, but
good.
The knee. He's going to be able to get a big punish on that. Look at the damage.
Crouch short walks up. Get the grab.
Just a tiny little bit of life left.
Keep that pressure on. Dashing forward.
Oh, just walks into it.
EX plus frames. Got to watch out. Here you go, Benda in the face. EX, those things are coming.
Oh, no uppercut. No uppercut.
He has V-Trigger. What's he going to do with it?
Oh, he can still get
DP, he gets it.
There it is right there. Julio getting step kick. V-Trigger cancel. Uppercut.
That was a lot. I don't know, there was a lot of suspect play there, but that's what happens in these tense matches, you know? Like, you have to go with things that aren't on paper, very smart, but in the heat of battle, you have to make a choice. You just have to do something.
Whew.
That'll wake you up a little, James.
One of the things, what you can actually do with these chairs, you can do this.
You're gonna knock that side down, man.
Man,
That's pretty cool, actually.
Yeah. Oh, man.
We've got a little replay here we're gonna check out. This is kind of...
Yeah, where does he sneak in this V skill?
It's the step kick, but look at that. He's playing so nervous.
V skill right there,
boom.
And it just happened to touch a button. Wow.
Great timing.